If you look closely at the state rankings in 6A, you'll see 8 of the top 10 boys teams are from North Texas. So it's pretty safe to say one, maybe even two area teams could be heading to state this year. One of the favorites is the Denton Guyer Wildcats, a team that was in the spot last year, the exact same spot, but fell just short of San Antonio. But as our North Texas Honda dealer's inside story found out, for one Wildcat, it's just another fight he refuses to lose.
It was at a restaurant just outside of Memphis, Tennessee, where an unbreakable bond began between Denton Guyer stars Davion Harmon and Jalen Wilson. They were just second graders and on their way to the AAU Nationals in Memphis. It would be the first time they ever met, and that weekend was the first time they would see just how dominant they could be together.
The first year we played, we went to Nationals against everybody in the nation. That I still see players to this day from, and we got third place. First time we ever made each other. Didn't even know names like that. So, you know, ever since then we just clicked.
And you look back on it now, you're like, wow, like, I mean, and we're still here, we're doing this thing together, we're both going to school. But just the journey, you know, that me and Jalen have been on together, at some point, you know, early it was bigger than basketball.
And they're still doing it quite well. Jalen and Davion have been starters at Guyer since they were freshmen and have the Wildcats ranked number 2 in the state. Since they've been together, Guyer has changed its reputation from being a football school to a basketball school. Last year, Guyer was nationally ranked and number 1 in the state. They were thought to be a shoe-in for the state tournament until they ran into Allen. The Eagles were a team Guyer had beaten twice earlier that season, but Allen slowed the game down and crushed Guyer's dreams 40-36.
And I remember I stayed in bed for like 2-3 days. You know, because spring break was coming up, so I just stayed at home and, you know, I replayed the game in my head, like it had to be like 8 to 10 times.
We've had these great teams and haven't been able to like show for it, you know, when it really counts. So I feel like there is pressure on us, but at the end of the day, like, the pressure like doesn't make us fold anything. Like, I've been used to pressure my whole life.
To be honest with this team, I like a little pressure. Jalen, Davion, both, when they're under a little pressure, I mean, and they're focused, they're tough to handle.
That loss has fueled the fire to make that trip to San Antonio. But it's a fire that's been inside Harmon literally since birth. Davion's mother, Lakita, started having contractions earlier than she was supposed to and had to rush to the hospital.
When they couldn't stop the contractions, they had to break my water. And they found out that he was in meconium. And so he went into distress. So that's when they had to do an emergency C-section. And everything just moved so fast.
Lakita says, is something wrong? And I said, no, they're just dealing with D. They're cleaning him up. Well, he hadn't cried yet. And I'm like, oh, well, the doctor hadn't spanked him on the butt. And no, they normally cry pretty soon.
Doctors told the Harmons that because of meconium that was released in the womb, had Davion cried like most babies, it could have been tragic.
The doctor comes in and says, you know, we didn't want to let you know at that time, but he was literally about 15 seconds away from death.
It was just a little scary. They weren't sure if he get to come home with us, but like he just, for some reason, they say, well, he's a fighter. He's definitely a fighter.
Davion's parents never told him the story until 6 years ago. And now he knows just how close he was to not being here at all. And he's used that as motivation and to maintain a fighter's mentality on the basketball court.
Definitely why I'm like that. Because I'm probably not even supposed to be sitting in this chair talking to you right now. I still think about it to this day, like, you know, that's why I work so hard. You know, that's why, you know, I play with a chip on my shoulder. I'm doing what I love to do every day. So that fight will always be in me.
And Guyer picked up 2 more wins this week and has clinched the 5-6A title. Do not be surprised if the Wildcats make another long playoff run this year.